1984. The beginning of the end. A world at war. The decline of individuality and the fall of originality. As we seek our immortality, the crusade has just begun. In 1984, the foundation will be built for a kingdom that will come.
Time we know. of emphasis is put on individual practicing by all the members of Warlord. It seems to become a way of life for us now. We practice as individuals a lot so that when we get together as a band and play, everybody seems to possess this unity of a band, yet still come across clearly as individuals. As a result of this individual practicing, the band seems to progress, as illustrated by the first release, Deliver Us, and the present, the video soundtrack. The video soundtrack is basically an anthology of the first 3 years of the band. We feel that we've conquered the first territory, now conquer the rest.
Thank you.
This is where the thunder is created for the five-man strike force known as Warlord. An ideology that is taken very seriously by this band is the belief that everything is done for a reason. Going back to the first release, Deliver Us, up to the present, we always believe in using our brains first to plan out our careers. Using this brains first philosophy has let us accomplish many of the goals that we set out to do. With this plan, we have went around a lot of pitfalls that a lot of other bands have fallen into. One of the things we do is not bite off more than we can chew. We're not the type of band to go play just for the sake of going to play.
We did the album releases because we wanted to release our material to the public. We did the video soundtrack because we wanted the world, not just a certain part of the country, to see what the band was like live. Now the next step is to play live, for the Cannons of Destruction have begun.
Influences of Warlord are basically a combination of different styles, ranging from the early Renaissance period to
to the classical works of Bach, Vivaldi, Paganini, and to the early works of Scorpions, Rainbow, Rush, UFO. I believe that heavy metal, or true heavy metal, is an art form. And this art form expresses power, aggression, sorrow, sometimes loud, sometimes quiet, but always powerful in its message. The importance of the classical influence in Warlord is that its complexities allow for certain harmonies, melodies, and modes to create a certain mood in the air. This mood or feeling depends upon the lyrical concept. The lyrical influences of the band come basically from my own personal philosophical outlook on our times and from up above. Music without deep, meaningful lyrics is like a painting without colors. You cannot separate lyrics and music. It's funny, we've been quoted many times as being a satanic band. And if they read the lyrics to deliver us from evil, which in their own ignorance they probably didn't even do, they would know that we're not. In the future, you can expect to hear songs like Battle of the Living Dead, Lost Archangel, Thy Kingdom Come, Achilles' Revenge, just to name a few. These songs will represent the true melodic power of Warlord. It's like Beethoven said once, if I knew as much about war as I know about music, then I would show the nations and the governments who was really powerful.
Thank you.
We'd like to take this opportunity to thank all the members of the Warlord Battle Choir for their sincere help and dedication over the last few years.
And all the people that made this video possible.
And for those who've been fighting for us overseas and abroad from the beginning to the end, deliver us from evil this day.
Deliver us from evil, we pray.